Hey guys, here we are back on Westbridge. Have some nice evening lighting going on here, so updated the dirt textures on this combine, but haven't updated the textures on the corn header yet. So that guy's out. So I think what we'll do is we'll set up a overload course. Can run this guy on course play, so we'll start our course recording there and drive over here and put our pause, and then stop there, overload from recording. Kenworth, their manual transmission. So I went ahead and separated the UV maps on these Wilson trailers. I didn't bother to do it for the TAG trailers because, you know, we running a 1500 bushel car, not a 2000. So, and I never ever used the little TAG trailer anyways. So we will go ahead and hop in our Challenger here. Finish up some of our plowing, or cultivating, I should say. Still can't get over this new lighting mod by Sirius. It's really great, actually. Offset is off. that works. Glance mod up in our top left so we can keep eye on our hired equipment. Looks like our combine is blocked as it unloads. We have some nice dust animations on our soil conditioner now. Turn a little wide. Still getting used to pulling this behind the cultivator here. Beautiful S680 working on the S670 version with folding tanks to be washable. Missed the folding tank operation, so thank you. pretty much all we have is corn in our fields right now. Next, we'll probably do some wheat or barley so we can use our new 645 Draper that converted. Clearly our hired worker missed some corn over here. Well, what can you do? So I'm really happy with this rig. It actually makes tilling fun. Playing with such beautiful mods and great, you know, air-free, such large folding equipment. I'm playing on Westbridge right now because I'm a save game on my Wind Chaser. It's all the tillage is finished. It's almost harvest time, so that's why I'm on this map testing these the new equipment. Up our cultivator and leave our conditioner. So I hope you guys are liking the quality of these videos now. I purchased iAction and seems to record a lot better. It's more stable, doesn't crash my computer, and still get high quality recordings, and it records in an MP4 and encodes while it records, so it's a smaller file, you know, like 8 to 10 gigs instead of 150. So